everybody, the most important people in the room have taken their seats, so would you all like to do the same? Well, good afternoon, everybody. My name is Beverly Edwards, and I'm one of the Deputy Superintendent Registrars with Sefton Council, and it's on their behalf that it's wonderful to welcome you all here to the Ramada Plaza Hotel in Southport. A very, very special occasion, obviously, for Joanne and Paul, and it's wonderful to see so many people here have sharing in their happiness. Now, you'll notice that, as always, we've come mob-handed. At least thanks to that programme that's been on, people do now realise that we go out in twos. You've been watching it well, with a vested interest at the moment. This is Chris Sixsmith, and she has the very important job of completing all the legal documents that go with the wedding. So we've already made a good start on finding out all about the couple. We interviewed them in a room that's allocated for that purpose. And as a result of that, she's made a very good start on the certificate. She's allowed to do that before the marriage takes place. However, Chris is not allowed at all to write in the register until a very significant moment in the ceremony. Okay? That's the point at which the couple are actually married. So I always like to tell people that before we start a marriage, because if we get to the end and she hasn't finished what she's doing, I wouldn't like you all to go home thinking, well, why did she sit there for so long and do nothing? And the other reason I like to tell people is that when Chris picks her pen up and writes in the register, it has been known for a spontaneous round of applause to break out amongst the people at the ceremony because they realise the significance of the moment. I like to think it's that, not just that they're so relieved that she's actually found her pen. Now, that document there is incredibly important, the register. That is the legal record of what goes on in here today. And when that register, which holds 50 records, is complete, it will be stored in the strong room in the town hall in Southport. And any of you that have watched that programme will know what else goes on in doesn't happen at all. It will be stored away, and when it's stored away, it will be joining the records that date back to 1837. So, Joanne and Paul, you're making history here today, and I like to think that at some point in the future, somebody doing their family tree will want to know what happened to Paul and Joanne on this day, in this place. They'll dig that very record and have a look at it. And I think that's a nice thing to think of. So shall we start? Now the very first thing I need to do is confirm that I'm marrying the right people. And the easiest way to do that is to ask you both to tell me your full name, okay? I've already explained to you that throughout the ceremony, it will be the groom who speaks first, okay? So please tell me your full name.
Paul Thomas.
And you are?
Jerome Bateson.
Well, that's great. We've got the right people. We're in the right place. We can carry on. Now, there's certain things that I have to tell you, and this is the first one of those. This place in which we are now met has been duly sanctioned according to law for the celebration of marriages. You are all here today to witness the joining in matrimony of Paul Thomas and Joanne Bateson and the start of their new life together as husband and wife. I'm sure that it means a great deal to them that you can be here to share their happiness and witness their marriage ceremony. Paul and Joanne, the purpose of marriage is that you may always love, care for, and support each other through the joys and the sorrows of life. Marriage means making a commitment for life, to developing and maintaining cooperation, friendship, and mutual respect. It calls for trust, understanding, and encouragement. Paul and Joanne have found in each other happiness, fulfillment, and love. And as a consequence of this, they now wish to affirm their relationship and to offer to each other the security which comes from legally binding vows, sincerely made and faithfully kept. However, here's the next bit that I have to say. If any person here present knows of any lawful impediment to this marriage, then they should declare it now. Please keep breathing. It's very important. I think we're safe. I don't think we need to breathe. So if if you're ready, would you like to take your positions as deputy? Additionally, you'd be on this side, that's exactly what you mean. Just don't stand on the... But please face me for this first detective. Paul and Joanne, before you joined in matrimony, it's my duty to remind you of the solemn and binding character of the vows that you're about to make. Marriage, according to the law of this country, is the union of two people, voluntarily entered into, for life, to the exclusion of all others. It's a deep and lasting commitment which should not be entered into lightly. So, you know that nobody in this room knows of any legal reason why you can't get married. But I have to check and make sure that neither of you is harbouring a deep dogs. You've chosen to declare that you are free to be married by repeating some words after me. So I'm going to start. Please repeat. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Paul Thomas.
Why I, Paul Thomas.
May not be joined in matrimony.
Not be joined in matrimony.
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 To Joanne
Bateson. Joanne
Bateson. Just in case
that makes sense. Those are big words, aren't they?
Are you ready? Let's show how it's done. Okay. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Joanne Bateson.
Why I, Joanne Bateson.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Paul Thomas.
To Paul Thomas.
Well done, girl. Paul and Joanne, you've both declared that you're legally free to marry each other. So we now come to the most important part of the ceremony, which is where you will take each other to be husband and wife. But I have to check and make sure that neither of you is doing this against your will. So I'm going to ask you a question. And you're going to respond in the way that we rehearsed. Okay. Do you, Paul, wish to take Joanne to be your wife?
I do.
And do you, Joanne, wish to take Paul to be your husband?
I do.
So, the ceremony here today gives you all the opportunity to meet together and to share in Paul and Joanne's happiness. We've reached the crux of the ceremony. This is where they're going to take each other to be husband and wife. So if you're able to do so comfortably, can I ask you all to stand? When two people pledge their love and care for each other in marriage, they create a unique spirit which binds them closer than any spoken or written words. Paul and Joanne, I'm now going to invite you to create your own spirit in marriage. As you take each other to be husband and wife. And for this, you probably want to look at each other. You may want to hold hands. So you're going to repeat after me, but don't worry, I will move over there when it's your turn, Joanne, so that you're not looking over your shoulder, okay? So please repeat after me. I call upon these persons here present.
I call upon these persons here present.
To witness that I, Paul Thomas.
To witness that I, Paul Thomas.
Do take thee, Joanne Bateson.
Do take thee, Joanne Bateson.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
I promise to give you my love and friendship.
I promise to give you my love and friendship.
And to be there for you when you need me most.
And to be there for you when you need me most.
To laugh with you and to cry with you.
To laugh with you and to cry with you.
To confide in you and to trust you.
To confide in you and to trust in you.
To comfort and support you.
To comfort and support you.
All that I have, I share with you.
All that I have, I share with you.
I promise to respect you and to be faithful always.
I promise to respect you and be faithful to you always.
These promises I make to you for the rest of my... Oh, I beg your
pardon.
These promises I make to you for the rest of my life.
These promises I make to you for the rest of my life.
I'm going to move up here just so that Joanne's not looking over the shoulder. She should be looking straight at us. Are you ready, Joanne?
Yeah.
Better. I call upon these persons here present.
I call upon...
I call
call upon me to place my faith in you.
To witness that I, Joanne Bateson,
to witness that I, Joanne Bateson,
do take thee, Paul Thomas,
do take thee, Paul Thomas,
to be my lawful wedded husband.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
I'm really sorry, I know this is so pedantic, would you just say lawful wedded husband?
Lawful wedded husband.
Thank you. I promise to give you my love and friendship.
I promise to give you my love and friendship.
And to be there for you when you need me most. To laugh with you and to cry with you.
To laugh with you and to cry with you.
To confide in you and to trust you.
To confide in you and to trust you.
To comfort and support you.
To comfort and support you.
All that I have, I share with you.
All I have, I share with you.
I promise to respect you.
I promise to respect you.
And be faithful always.
And to be faithful always.
These promises I make to you for the rest of my life.
These promises I make to you for the rest of my life.
So, the eagle-eyed amongst you will have noticed that Chris now has a pen in her hand and is writing away. You are well and truly naive. To the exchange of rings, and that is the traditional way of sealing the contract that you have already entered into. A ring is used because it's an unbroken circle, it's got no beginning and it's got no end, and it symbolises unending love, which very clearly flows between the two of you. And Neil's getting a bit of friendship on this. Rings are objects of adornment, and while in a lifetime we may have many objects of adornment, we will always have among them the one that's most precious to us. It's my hope that these rings, from this day forward, will be your most treasured adornment, and that the love that they symbolise throughout your lifetime will be your most precious possession. So, this is your big moment, Neil. Yes. Could you please take the ring, the appropriate ring?
Which one?
It's the smaller of the two, usually. And it's the one that is going to give Joanne. Have you got the right one?
Yeah.
So if you could place that on the third finger of Joanne's left hand, and as you hold it there, say these words to her. You say these words directly to her, and you're holding the ring. So look at that and hold the ring. I give you this ring. As a symbol of my love for you.
As a symbol of my love for you.
I promise to love you.
I promise to love you.
Care for you.
Care for you.
And respect you.
And respect you.
For the rest of my life.
For the rest of my life.
And it's gone all the way. Excellent. So now do you want to take the other window on? Definitely relaxing now. Any of us worrying about her? Definitely relaxing.
Nice to come up.
Okay, so the third finger of his left hand, that's it. Look at each other, so you might want to turn a little bit. Hand out to the pocket, thank you. Directly to him.
I give you this ring
as a symbol of my love for you. I promise to love you, care for you, and respect you for the rest of my life.
Darling, just dive right in.
Has it gone all the way?
Follow my lead.
That's it. You've made all declarations required by law. You've made solemn and binding promises to each other in the presence of all your family and friends.
I never knew you were the someone waiting for me. We were just kids when we fell. Bye.
call the surprise victor. Will you make round of
Joanne needs company. So off she talks. And I was swimming for her. And so I had to watch, and there she was, trying to find a person who would be her friend when I went holiday. And she just kind of stole my son and drove all of them. That's a girl, that's to her age. Did you not?
Yes.
So every holiday we went on, Joanne was never without a friend at all. Yeah.
Now, one of the other staff, Suvan, who organised the wedding, was the guest list, so he's here today. Walter made the cuts. It's important to us that our closest friends and family is today. I want to start off by thanking the bridesmaids. You all look amazing today, you guys. Well, thank you so much for the hard work you've been taking your car. I know it's a task on its own. Now, we'll move on to the ushers. I want to thank you for your hard work today. Although, at one point, seeing our William, I think you'll miss him. So, they've just seen him patting down people and checking bags. But we appreciate the very nice one. Both of us, can't thank you enough for how generous you've been with the wedding, so thank you very much. Also, I want to thank you for the way you welcomed me to your family as soon as you met me all. On to my mum and dad, I think we'd all like to thank you all for what an amazing job you've done.
You can't hear like that.
I don't think anyone would argue about that. Again, for me and Joe, we both want to thank you for our generous trip on the wedding. We can't thank you enough. You've been amazing for all your help. You've been the best parents I ever wished for growing up. And you will be there for me. Most of you know me best man. Yay! You would be perfect for the job with all this best man experience and that. Personally, would like to thank you for agreeing to be my best man. And if I can't think of anyone else to do a better job, thank you very much. You do have a gift for you, but I'm not going to watch you for this. Can anyone please give a big round of applause to how great Joe looks today? You look amazing, more beautiful than I've ever seen you before. Aww. Can you enjoy that in one of the most romantic locations ever? Bentley's in Lancaster. I don't know that. It was around 3 o'clock in the morning and I was debating whether to get off and get a takeaway or just stay. Catching your eye was Joe getting an airbag by a mate who was so trying to get the whole family. After when we first made eye contact, I knew straight away she was a keeper of what she first said to me. What are you looking at?
Thank you.
That's probably the Queen of the this avenue. But that song, we just raise our glasses. We're very grateful to the guys the monster in the room behind Barry. I looked at our James and
And he walked in the direction of the ring, and the colour drained from his face. There was a big silence as we looked at each other. And I said, "Claire Paul, you'll be fine." Straight away, Fanny said, "Perfect, get ready." And you'll probably think, "What shitbag I am. I've never seen a woman like this before, she's been animals." As Paul made his approach to the ring, myself and James followed to support him in his impossible task. Well, I was thinking of a shabby phone. I noticed Paul's face when he seen his opponent, he was breaking it. The only advice I had, being his older cousin, was, "Don't worry about that, she's only a woman." No normal one. Paul went into the ring, the bell rang, the fight. Now I would love to tell all of you, you know, the sparring session was a success, but it lasted 1 minute 30 seconds. I've never seen a male take so much punishment in that time in my whole life. There was one punch that nearly knocked his head off, and the slap of noise from Paul's head was saving me for the rest of my life. It was awful. After the fight, we found out the woman was a semi-pro boxer and a prison woman in Morton. Paul still has nightmares to this day, and I thought it would put him off my room full stop, so don't be lucky. Right, lads, now I've asked some of the men in the room, not the married men, for some pearls of wisdom for you. Paul, firstly, set some ground rules and establish some rules and establish some boss. Then do what Joe says. Remember to tell your wife the three little important words, your idea. Remember the five rings, engagement ring, wedding ring, suffering, torturing, enduring. Joe, welcome to our family. Paul's a great lad. And they'll make it face awesome, look after them. And I really do wish you both, you know, a happy life together. And I both hope that you enjoy your honeymoon in Wales. I assume that's where you're going, because when I asked Paul what your plans were after the wedding, he told me he was going to bang you for a fortnight. Thomas. Thanks very much.